Drifters who killed two people in a drug-fueled Bay Area crime spree learned their fates today. KPIX 5's Emily Turner was at the sentencing in San Rafael, where we heard from the widow of one victim and from one of his killers. Emily?
It was an emotional day in court, to say the least, and whether or not this will bring closure to the victims' families has yet to be seen. But one thing is certain, they're very glad that this part of the healing process is over.
The unbearable grief and the pain and the trauma that your actions have caused me personally have been just too much to bear.
562 days after the murder of Steve Carter, his killers faced the harsh words of his family. Only Lila Alligood shed a tear.
I feel so much guilt and shame for the wrongdoing and the horrible decisions that I made. And I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
Thank you. She, along with Morrison Lampley and Sean Angold, are convicted of killing Steve Carter in October of last year on a Marin trail, and Audrey Carey days before in Golden Gate Park.
I believe that no punishment, however harsh, can ever really do justice to these crimes that were committed. The crimes were unforgivable, without remorse pretty much, and fully intentional.
Morrison Lampley will serve a minimum of 100 years to life without parole. Lila Alligood will serve 50, but may be eligible for parole after 25 because she was only 18 when she committed the crime. But Sean Angold, believed to be the ringleader of them all, will only serve a minimum of 15 years and could be out earlier on parole thanks to the plea deal he cut with the prosecution to testify against the other two.
In a drug-induced craze, you became cold-blooded murderers. So now, prepare to pay for it.
And in addition to their prison time, each of these convicted murderers also has to pay $10,000 to each of the victims' families on top of court fees and restitution.
Well, Emily, we had a chance to hear from Lila Alligood there. She seemed remorseful. She was crying. Did either of the other killers speak in court?
They both wrote a statement where they apologized, said they were remorseful. They hope that the families can find peace, but neither one of them read it. In fact, they had their attorneys read it for them while they were sitting in the courtroom. Veronica.
All right, Emily Turner live for us there in San Rafael. Emily, we appreciate it. Thank you.